gozaimasu, minasan. Good morning, everyone. It's our second day, well, second full day in Japan, and we're going to Harajuku. Oh, I'm so excited. We're spending multiple times in Harajuku on our trip, but for the first day, we're just going to Takeshita Dori, which is a little more touristy. It's the famous street that you go down. It's usually quite crowded and lots of really cute shops and crepes. Just to ease us into Harajuku, best to just do the basic walk today. It is 100% chance of rain today. I can hear the rain. So we had to cancel going earlier to see the Meiji Shrine. Just had to slightly change plans, but Harajuku is going to be ducking in and out of shops, so we'll only get a little bit wet, hopefully.
Check out this vlogger over here.
Is this vlogception?
Hi, so this is our outfits for today. So you might be wondering why us, big fans of the later fashion and stuff, of Fairy Kate even, are not wearing later fashion or anything. Because Takeshita Dori, the street we're going in Harajuku today, is loaded with tourists all the time. You will get stopped like every few seconds if you're wearing later or something, which is really stressful and exhausting. People have warned you about it. So it's best to like dress casual, and that way we can try and close easier as well. So other times we're going to Harajuku, like different places, we can wear the later, but Takeshita Dori, gotta take it a bit easy. But even then, Jules might get stopped because she is really cute, and some tourists are going to be like, oh, is that Lolita? Because you know, people like anything that has like a big bow, and it's like, oh, are you one of those doll girls?
Laced on the bottom as well.
Hotel, let us take umbrellas that they had out ready for today because everyone's got umbrellas. Just a giant TV. Meiji Shrine anyway, but it's quite a walk, so we will come here another day. At least we know it's really easy to get to. We're here! Takeshita Dori! Yay! And of course it's really busy. Actually, this is actually semi-quiet for Takeshita Dori because it's already okay, I'm already overwhelmed. Let's go home.
Are those coupons?
Sure.
Yes. I got piercing, so this is really exciting.
There's a lot of cute turkey stuff here. Really cute, but I've been dreaming of finding stuff like this.
So I spend a lot. First kids, dream of cheese. It's a classic. Look at these bunnies. I almost got them, but they look really fragile. Sushi nori paper. cute chopsticks, and you can also get special engraved spoons and forks. Oh, and even knives.
Yosh!
So cute! These are all kittens. Funny! Very cute.
It's a mushy mushy box. I'll probably come past it again when it's a nicer day, but it's so nice to like pass it. It's kind of weird seeing it in person for the first time. Yay! Inside, like, look, there's all these kawaii plastic toys. Oh, look at it. And it has all the times. Oh, around the world. It's 6:30 back at home in London. Wait, what? What time is it? It could be 6:30 soon. Oh my god, the times are dead. Oh, it's already depressing. We should definitely come back another time. On our way to Kawaii Monster Cafe. Ominous. This is the Kawaii Monster Cafe menu. I've definitely been fantasizing about having magic colorful pasta. Apparently it's got quite unique flavors on the sauces. Like, what's the blue? These are some of the crazy desserts. That cat food is definitely new. That is so funny. That's amazing. And drinks. Some of the drinks are really fun. Like, you know, you make like a little mad scientist drink. And some of these look really, really nice, like fresh fruit drinks. Oh my goodness, it's so cute! Ah. He's still watching me, he's still watching. Oh no.
This is the big monster, his name is Choppy.
Oh, konnichiwa Choppy. It's like wide open right now.
Oh my goodness.
It's the menu.
This whole time, but it's just the
and chopsticks.
So cute.
Ah!
This looks like it's fizzy, but it's not. It's just plain water.
What I got was an eyeball drink. I don't know what it means, but it sounds delicious anyway. Jules has got like, it's a green tea drink. And Emily has a magnificent looking strawberry tower of like some magic cream marshmallow mix here. Here's our dinner. It's super, super cute rainbow pasta. I've been dreaming of having this for like at least a year since I first saw this plate. Jules got it too. So Emily ordered a more traditional meal. It's interesting that they do these, they had like a little section of things like this. I guess it like shows off that the chef is actually, you know, a totally reputable chef. I just tried my drink. It tastes like Fry's Turkish Delight bars. You get them a lot in the UK, not sure where else, but it tastes just like that. It's amazing. This is really, really good. It's actually hitting the spot. You know how some people, I mean, are a bit nervous about theme cafes and that you're coming mostly for the looks? But this food is like completely genuinely delicious. Obviously I can't eat that little bit of meat there, but who cares, it's all colorful. If you're wanting to know the sauces, this is like a chili ketchup. This is a mustard. Green's like a pesto, basil pesto. This is cheese, and this is like a cream. I'm so glad I finally know what they taste like. I was like, what are they? And especially that. That's a work of art. Oh, she's so cute. She drew us all a little individual picture each while we were sitting here. And she even spelled my name right, she asked. So sweet. What a treat. There's Julie. So cute. And Emily got we're like totally tackling this. We're tackling this one. By the way, this is proper real vanilla ice cream. It's got vanilla bits in. This is really good stuff. I thought this might be quite artificial. It's not. It's really proper, delicious food. Good stuff. Well done, Koi Monster Cafe. So that's the card edge of it done. The fallen stomach monster card. I think we all got these cute little autographs from the Koi Monster Cafe girls. I feel like I met celebrities today. I kept seeing them online for a long time. That's a cool shop. Goodbye, Koi Monster Cafe. That's such a lovely welcome to Harajuku. I didn't realize there was a gift shop.
About
£10.
Yeah, it's
quite
expensive. Maybe a badge, something I can like wear.
Yeah. Yeah, gift shop. That's cute. This is above the station. Hi, I'm Olet from the rain, but guess who? This is Brianna.
Hello. We were just trying to find a restroom, and afterwards we got lost, and Brianna was here, and she was like, I like your videos of like...
Yeah, it's so great.
I met someone that watches my videos all the way in Japan.
Yes.
Thank you so much. So it made my day, but I'm also kind of like, this is a cosmic.
Yeah,
you
see.
It was lovely to meet you.
Thank you so much.
Jules just went to and bought her doggies at Pitbird House, a very sweet gift. I just went to WC, it was so cute, look at it. Thank you so much to the super lovely shop assistant. Let's try on my first Leslie sound. Right? Just yay. Jules, it's her shop. Pom pom pudding, cafe time. What's this? Pom pom pudding cafe. Here's our little pom-pom pudding friend. I got iced cocoa. Look, it's pom-pom pudding and his little friends.
I love his face here. He's so cute. I have to eat you.
Even got some little crushed Oreo pieces. I used some chocolate after a long day in the rain. Jules has a strawberry yogurt pen. So cute, her little strawberry and her sponge. Yay! No! Yeah! Itai!
Demo. Ham. Sorry. That was like a dessert. That was way bigger than we thought. I loved it. He's under there. Hi, Bumblebee.
Thank you.
We came back to our hotel and find Evie like this. Oh my gosh, our cleaner is so sweet. So this is the carnage from our first day in Arachico. Or should I say, that's just mine. Amazingly, I came home and I realized I was perfectly on budget. Oh boy. So firstly, here's what I got from Paris Kids. I went shopping crazy at Paris Kids. I've always wanted to go since I was a teenager. And they had so many cute fairy cave things, as you hear. So for me, I got like, I was so excited to finally get some like bigger, more kawaii hair ties for my pigtails that I'm always wearing. So there's another one there. Some more cute musical note, a cute badge. Very key things, this is so cute, this pony. Some more hair ties. Don't judge me that I got two almost identical set of ribbon ties. This is a more mature pink, so it's for other outfits. Well, this is more cutesy pink, okay. That's a cute choco mint style dangle. Got a choker, and these are less fairy key things here, except these adorable heart earrings. Now, earrings, they sell a bunch of clip-on earrings, so you don't need pierced ears. I don't have any pierced ears, but now I'm willing to experiment with some cute earrings. So there's some teddies with bows there, and I got this cute little kind of more mature style moon necklace and a moon clip, again kind of the more mature pink of this. Also, I got some things for my friends here, so that's some extra stuff. And because I bought so much with our new friend Emily, like, I just know, I didn't notice they put this in my bag, but the people at Paris Kids put in 3 10% off Sanrio Pearland tickets would be perfect, but I don't think they're valid when we're going to Pearland. But it was so sweet that she put 3 in 1 for each of us. Then we went to WeGo. I was actually amazed. I didn't realize WeGo was like almost like a Primark full of different things. I thought it was literally a fashion shop. So yeah, I basically bought this whole outfit off the mannequin that was up at the front of the store because I loved it so much. Their size is quite large, so good for me when you're a Westerner and you're not quite sure if you're going to fit. And this collar is separate, but such a cute idea. This adorable UFO pochette purse, some cute storage hearts, and adorable bunny hair ties. Oh yes, more hair ties. And I got these Kirby sweets for some friends. Now WC, or W heart C, was the highlight of my day to day in Harajuku, and obviously limited amount of time in shops we went to, but WC put out my expectations. The staff were so lovely. It was a really, really fun little experience. So WC is like a sub branch of WeGo, but they have this adorable character called Esther Vani. So I got this t-shirt with her on. She's such like a great, like, I went to Harajuku character. I really love her design as well. And I got this. This is vintage. Their upper floor is all vintage or secondhand recycled clothes. This MTV top is really, really big, but it's cute oversized. And these were actually from the WeGo shop, but they're part of the WC line. Some socks and a cute bunny butch. I got my own Esther bunny. I had to choose between pink or white, but I chose pink. And yeah, it's probably obvious, but I noticed she was pink in all of these things. So, and I got this cute WeGo skirt. I love their skirts. And lastly, the shop attendant was so, so sweet. And she was like, oh, you're wearing a Polly Pocket t-shirt. She's just so, so cute and nice. And she gave me this for free, this little paper bag. And she was like, oh, make sure it doesn't get wet in the rain, though. And like, she put all my stuff in like an extra bag and stuff to protect it from the rain. And in fact, on the day, WC had a 10% off rainy day discount. But now, are you guys ready for my damage from Daiso? Damage from Daiso. Oh boy, don't worry, I had planned to do this. I'll have to do this really fast, but okay. So firstly, we've got kitchen stuff. We've got My Melody kind of mug topper to keep your tea warm. Some adorable bunny bento shaper and a rocket shaper. I saw that in Abby Pop's video and I was like, oh, I'm so glad it was still there. Oh, I forgot to show these little cute little bento flags. Oh, I always wanted some cute ones from Japan. Some cute onigiri holders, some sushi nori cutouts so you can decorate your bento, which I wanted to get into once I got home. And now we're moving on to stationery. So we've got stir. And now we're moving on to stationery. So we've got cinema roll and My Melody letter writing set. We've got this cute star hole puncher card holder, which I'm going to use immediately for traveling so it's a little lighter. And some ice cream memo pads. Some cute stickers, so you can see the pictures there. Some cute kind of like highlighter Disney princess ones and some kind of generic cutesy ones, washi tape. The washi tape selection was a bit for me today, not too cute, but I really like these. And some sweets, I think they're like shaped like the characters inside. Some beauty stuff now, contact lens case, My Melody, just to try, like these Hello Kitty under eye things. I don't have eye bags, but I have sunken eyes, I don't know if that'll help. Some Snow White, they had all kinds of Disney princesses like blotting paper, which I'd like to try. And there's some Little Twin Stars patterned face wipes. I really want to try. I keep seeing those. They look really cute. This is a box that pops out, which is great for storage. Might be good for traveling home too. A picnic blanket for sitting at Disneyland. A duster, a bunny-shaped duster. Wow. Jules recommended I get some of these. These like vacuum pack clothes, which will be good for traveling home. And I got this hand towel with a bunny on. I couldn't resist. Cute, friendly friend. And even the hang of it there's got a bunny on. Guys, that's not all I got from Daiso, because I also had to get some things for friends from Daiso. So for the mister, I got him some Gudetama things. I got some kind of traditional Japanese chopsticks. There's some more kawaii chopsticks to share around. Several packs of My Melody face wipes. Some more Disney Princess blotting paper. I can share some of my girly friends. Some Mario sweets. Some of these adorable otter stationery stickies and some Nico, Lucky Nico stickies, and these polar bear index. A lot of those are for the mister too. So guys, guess how much this damage did me from Daiso? Only £34. So yep, that was very fun. Whew, almost there. And our little tiny trip to the Pom Pom Pouring Cafe. I got some things purely for my friends, especially one of my friends who is a massive fan of Pom Pom Pouring, and I owe her for babysitting the bunnies. She wouldn't take payments, so she's getting lots of Pom Pom Pouring because it makes her cry. So some cute Pom Pom Pouring stickers. I like bread Pom Pom Pouring again. Some plates, and I got the bunny sitting friend. He's adorable. Pom Pom Pouring plushie, because it looks like he may be exclusive to the cafe. I am not sure. Yes, it is. Yay! Lastly, this is my little souvenir from the Quiet Monster Cafe. As you can assume, the gift shop is a little expensive, but defo love this badge. It's super hard to get. And I went to Listen Flavor and picked this Minhera-chan badge. The shop assistant stopped chatting with me. She came out, took a photo of me with the bag buying from Listen Flavor. She was just so, so sweet. Finally, that was my haul of today. It was just a little haul. Oh god. Well, I am thoroughly exhausted after that awesome trip to Harajuku today. This is my little dinner for tonight because I'm still pretty full from the Pom Pom Pouring Cafe drink. So I'll say goodnight for now. Bye, everyone. Oh yes, I mean goodbye.